is Silja, and I hope you all are having a wonderful day. Today I will do a book haul because last weekend I went to London to visit Elizabeth from Bookish North, and on Friday we went and met Mark Nash and we went on this bookshop crawl, and of course I bought some books. The first book is the book that I'm currently reading, and that is Planetfall by Emma Newman. This is the first book in the Planetfall series, and it's a sci-fi, and I am enjoying it immensely. Yeah, I will be talking more about this on Sunday. I will do a reading week, reading weeks video then, but yeah, it's really good. Yesterday I went on a hunt for the second book in this series. I couldn't find it anywhere. So that's a bummer, but yeah, it's really good. Another book that I bought is by an author that I have been meaning to read for quite a while now, and that is Christopher Isherwood. I ended up with A Single Man mainly because I am very curious about the movie by Tom Ford with Colin Firth. But this is about an English professor who has lost his partner. This one. Another book that I bought on kind of a random is Triangulum by Masande, Ntshanga. This is a South African science fiction dystopian kind of novel, I think. It is written as a message from the future. We meet a schoolgirl who is haunted by the loss of her mother, but who are visited by this machine. It's also about science and eco-theorism. It has some philosophical elements, coming of age elements. It's also about the history of South Africa. And yeah, I think it sounds pretty awesome. I also bought another book on the whim, and that is Cult X by Fuminori Nakamura. This is translated from Japanese by Xiaolu Guo, Almony. And this is inspired by the 1995 terrorist attack on the Tokyo subway. And it's about a man whose girlfriend goes missing, and he is looking for her. And I do think he finds her in this compound as a part of this cult. And some of the themes are how people get drawn towards extremism, and that is a subject that I am very fascinated by. Sadly, this has got quite some bad reviews on Goodreads, but I will give it a go. A book that I was actively looking for is this book. This is Case Histories by Kate Atkinson. This is the first book in the Jackson Brody series, which is described as this literary mystery series. The reason why I was looking for this is because Sarah at Hardcover Hearts has talked about it and very much enjoys it. And she recommended Jane Harper to me, which I loved. So yeah, I think Sarah is my go-to when it comes to mysteries and crime fiction. This is set in Cambridge, and Jackson Brody is a private investigator, and he is working on three different cases, and I do think they are all like interwoven in some way. But yeah, I look forward to read it. Mark Nash also recommends it, so yeah, I think I'm safe. Another book that I picked up was White by Marie Darrieussecq, and I have read one book by her previously, that was Being Here, which was a biography about Paula Modersohn Becker. She was a German expressionist painter, and that biography was fantastic. I always think about it as a novel, but it is a biography, but it was so beautifully written. So yeah, I'm eager to dive into her fiction. This is set in Antarctica, and we are following a man and a woman who are working on a project there. They both have secrets from the past that they are running from. And I do think this will be like a intense chamber play set in a remote place, which is something that I very much enjoy reading about. Another book that I think is a me book is this one, I Who Have Never Known Men by Jacqueline Harpman. Jacqueline Harpman is a, well, was a Belgian author, and this book is considered a French-Belgian cult classic. It's translated by Ros Schwartz, and this is about 39 women who are imprisoned in cages underground, and they don't have any recollection for why they're there. They don't remember their past. And then prisoner number 40 arrives. It's a young woman, and she seems to be the key to everything. And I do think this is kind of dystopian, but I'm not sure, but I am very curious. Maggie Nelson is an author that I have been curious about for, I think, years now. And she is very well known for her books Bluettes and The Organauts. But the book that has really piqued my interest is this one. This is The Red Parts, Autobiography of a Trial. And this is about Maggie Nelson's aunt, who was found brutally murdered outside her campus in 1969. And it's also about the trial that took place 30 years after. So it's both like true crime and also a reflection on a trial. And it's also about violence in general, and more specific about violence towards women. Maggie Nelson has also written another book about Jane, which is called Jane, and that is a long poem. I am pretty curious about that one as well, but I would read this one first. The reason why I picked this up now was because Bert and Sean at Shawnee Reads recently talked about it, and they made me remember to look for it. Then I have a Chinese book, 20 Fragments of a Ravenous Youth by Xiaolu Guo. And this is translated from the Chinese by Rebecca Morris. And this is set in Beijing, and we meet the main character, Fen Fang. She is in her early 20s, and she has left her parents' farm, and she wants to live a modern life in Beijing. She is a movie extra. And this is described as a nihilistic Generation X manifesto. I'm in. Then I have another science fiction. This is a graphic novel, and this was recommended by Damien at Sleepy Reader 666. And this is Skyward by Henderson, Garbett, Fabela, and Bowland. And this is a story about what happens if gravity almost disappears from Earth, or that's like the ground premise, and I am eager to read this. And last but not least, I have another graphic novel. This was recommended by both Damien and also Chaos and Comics. This is Curse Words by Charles Soule and Ryan Browne, and it's a fantasy set in New York. It has a wizard. But the main reason for me picking this one up is because of the talking koala. Because, of course, I want to read a book about the talking koala. And the koala's name is Margaret. It's perfect. That was the books that I bought in London and that I brought with me to Paris. If you have read some of them, please let me know in the comments what you thought about them. I really like talking with you in the comments. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and until next time, ha det!